Good day, chess fans, especially the Pinoy chess fans out there. And we are back. This is round two of the Grand Chess Tour. And this is the pairing. And you can see that Grandmaster Wesley So is against Grandmaster Shakir Mamedyarov. I still have difficulty pronouncing Mamedyarov's first name. And it has already started. And Wesley So is white against Mamedyarov. So we have here our game, so we can go back so we can see what opening they did played. So here we have Wesley So moving first with d4 and knight f6 by Mamedyarov, c4 and e6, and then g3 and d5, bishop g2, and takes on c4, knight f3. So Wesley just allowed that he be a pawn down here, and then a6 and castling, and knight c6. And what do we have here? So Wesley is in no hurry to take back that pawn. He just proceeded with e3, supporting his d4 pawn, and rook b8, queen e2, and b5. So as we can see here, Wesley was not really able to recover the pawn at c4. So maybe this is a strategy for him in order to take a different kind of advantage, maybe a strategic advantage on his part. So we have here b3, and c4 takes b3, and then ab3, and bishop d6, rook d1, queen e7, and bishop b2. So I still can't figure out why Wesley allowed that the situation here wherein he is a pawn down. So we can see, but actually he is also down on time. So is that a wrong strategic move for Wesley there, or does he have something in store for us? So we can see, let's see what would eventually play out here. Castling by Mamedyarov, and then rook c1. So you can see here Wesley have moved his rook already twice here, but in this instance it has a tempo, since he is attacking the black knight on c6. So Mamedyarov has not yet moved. So let's focus on this game. We have bishop b7 by Mamedyarov here, and it's Wesley's turn. But if you see the computer evaluation, it's actually just equal, and Wesley is still ahead by a very small percentage here, 0.31. and maybe that pawn sacrifice by Wesley really is a strategic sacrifice here. It would amount to something later that we cannot yet fathom at this point. Maybe you can fathom it, but for me, I cannot yet see the real reason for that pawn sacrifice right out in the opening. Okay, so Wesley had made his move here, and that's knight e5. So as you can see, the knight on e5 is protected by the bishop on b2 and the pawn on d4. So there would really be no additional pawn sacrifice here. It's just an exchange. He is forcing the exchange of pieces here, because if the knight declines to take on, if the knight on c6 declines to take on e5 or moves somewhere else, and then Wesley could exchange his light colored bishop at g2. Okay. Let's just wait for Mamedyarov to make his move. So that's it. Mamedyarov declines the exchange of knight and he goes to b4. So what would Wesley do here? I think an exchange of bishop would favor black because he is a pawn up, and any exchange of pieces would bring the game closer to the end game. And since he is a pawn up, then the end game is to black's advantage. So what would Wesley do here? Let's see. So while waiting for the... Oh, Wesley did exchange the bishop at b7, and then rook takes b7 by Mamedyarov. And let's see what happened to the rating of Wesley when he won against Fabiano. So the Rapid is really not that updated. The Rapid rating is not being updated in real time. Only the classical games are being updated in real time. Okay, let's go back to the game. Okay, so again here, Wesley is forcing the exchange of pieces here. So knight c6, since the queen is being threatened by the knight, then either the queen moves and then Wesley takes the knight on b4, and then bishop takes b4 by black, or Mamedyarov could just take with knight c6. Okay, so here Wesley is confident that despite being a pawn down, that he can recover that pawn. So as you can see here, Wesley, I think, would successfully recover that pawn by taking on a6 with rook a6. So what happened here is that with b3 in the opening and c takes b3 and a takes b3, the pawn at a6 is now not really that defended because Wesley successfully exchanged the bishop, the light squared bishop, against the light squared bishop of black. The pawn at a6 is now weak. Actually, it cannot be defended anymore. e5 by black here. If Wesley declines to exchange his bishop, then black or Mamedyarov could go e4, taking control of the weak squares of Wesley, which is at f3 and d3. But Wesley would not allow that. So there would be now an exchange of bishop here. And Wesley would take on a6 with using the rook at c6 in order to force an exchange of rook at the back rank of black. I think so, because he has to force that exchange because his own back rank is weak. So, what do you think, guys? I think so. I do think that because of the background weakness of Wesley, and he has some weak squares there, because of that, he would also force an exchange of rook by taking on a6 with a rook from c6 and then going rook a8. So let's see. So Mamedyarov is kind of fast though. He is ahead in time compared to Wesley. Oh, I was wrong. Wesley has a different idea here. So he took with the rook from a1. So what would be the purpose of that move? Okay. And then next move by Wesley would probably be, of course, knight d2, so that the knight could go to f3. I don't like the position of Wesley here. I'm not comfortable playing this kind of position. So we have a major of going or moving with rook d8. And he is actually threatening. If Wesley goes knight d2 here, and then it would be very dangerous for him, or Wesley actually loses the knight because of. If knight d2, he loses the knight because of queen b2. So that's not possible. So the only way for Wesley to get the knight out is for him to go knight c3. Oh, I really don't like the position of Wesley here. It's not. His pieces are uncoordinated. For me, this is my opinion of it. Wesley's pieces are not really coordinated. And it's dangerous for him to have that kind of position. And against an opponent like Mamedyarov, although if you see the evaluation of the computer, it's still fairly equal. Well, maybe the reason why the computer evaluates this as equal, as you can see here, and even though Wesley or White is evaluated to have a slight edge, but it's very minimal, just like a first move edge, because one of Black's rook is at b7, and at b7 it's not able to join in any attack that Black wants to execute. So that's the reason that the position is still evaluated as equal here. But if Wesley goes to, for example, Wesley goes to knight c3, the problem is b4, and the knight would be forced to go somewhere, and knight d1 would not be very good position to go, because it's awkward, because it's somewhat like a trap position. So I really don't think that's a good position for Wesley. However, if knight c3 then b4 and then going knight a4, seems to put the knight in a corner. And as we have learned in the principles of the opening, you don't put your knight in a corner. And if knight a4, then you have knight e4 by black, controlling d2, and what comes next is rook d2. But of course, before black could do that, he has to move, make a move, something like h6 or g6, so that the black king would be able to escape in case of a check on the black rank, because there is a threatened mate if the defense of the black rank would be forsaken or would be removed. For example, the defense, if the rook goes somewhere, then the only defender would be the queen, and would just be taken by the rook because the knight intends to go to e4. So, for example, if this move, rook d8, and then knight c3, and then b4, and then if knight a4, then we have knight e4. If knight a4 by white, knight e4. If knight a4 by white, then you have knight e4 by black, threatening rook d2. But before that, blacks got to move something like h6. Okay, but that would be a very strong attack by black. And Wesley would be forced to make a move like f3, weakening his position, but a Nizar evil in this position that he is into. And as you can see, Wesley is very much down on time compared to the time of Mamedyarov, and he has to do something about this and make a move now that maybe not really that much of a significance, since he is a development down in terms of development, but he has to make a move that would not put him too much at risk. Okay, maybe we could just wait for that. As you can see, Magnus Carlsen is not part of this your next move, Grandchester edition. It's not here in the pairings. What we have here is Anish Giri and Grishuk Alexander, and then fairly all of the people here are, almost all of them are part of the Altibax Norway chess. So we don't have Magnus, but we have Anish Giri, and I don't know what the other, but actually in the Altibax Norway, they all started with is that 10 players? Yeah, 10 players too, but Ding Liren withdrew from the tournament because of a injury before the cooking edition of the Norway chess. So they finished the tournament with only 9 players. So if we count Ding Liren, so Ding Liren was replaced by Grishuk Alexander, and Magnus Carlsen was replaced by Anish Giri. Okay. So that's it. That's what I have said, guys. It's necessary for black to move his pawn somewhere. So instead of h6, he moved it h5 in order to constrict the position of white. It actually supports a possible, this h5 here supports a possible knight g4. Okay, so what did Wesley did a while ago is, instead of knight c3, he did rook a2. Because he don't want knight c3, what he wants is knight d2. But knight d2, an immediate knight d2 here, instead of, if an immediate knight d2 here runs into queen b2, losing the knight. So What Wesley did is to first protect the B2, to protect B2 with rook A2, and then he intends to go knight D2, but the queen cannot anymore go to queen B2. So that's the purpose of this move, rook A2. Okay, so what happened next is H5 and knight D2. So the B2 square is now protected. The black queen cannot go there. And it's still Mamedyarov's turn. Okay. So after all, the move rook a to take a6 is a good move because if the c6 rook is the one that took here, it's the more awkward for white. What if it's here? It's awkward for white actually. At least here, the black rook, the other rook for white could go down to c1 if needed. Okay, so what black is doing here is trying to disrupt the position of white. It's making white, it's tempting white to take on h4, in exchange for that destroying the pawn structure of white. Okay, but if you don't take at h4, then black is threatening h3, actually causing a very dangerous threat, a psychological threat, sometimes maybe not a real threat immediately, but because if the pawn goes to h3, then you could imagine lots of possible back rank mates below because the pawn is at h3. But you could also not take on h4 because it would destroy your pawn structure. So here what Wesley is doing is knight f3 and then at the same time threatening the queen at e5 a while ago, so that the pawn at h4 could not immediately go to h3. So what Mamedyarov did is queen e4, so what's the threat here? The threat here is actually there is a direct threat at the pawn on, oh no, at the rook on c6, and so the rook now moved to c1 in order to protect the back rank of white. Okay, so computer evaluates now that black is actually ahead. Okay, so Mamedyarov was able to execute his plan of putting the pawn to h3. This is a very good position or place for the pawn here. So Wesley has doubled his rook. Wesley is on the defensive now. There is a real chance that Wesley would lose this game because black is already ahead here and has the initiative, and the one that causes the problems of Wesley is this. One of the problems that he has is this very awkward position of the b3 pawn. If this pawn falls, then the end game is very much to the advantage of Mamedyarov. So this pawn should not fall. Actually, this rook c2 is not really a threat because if rook takes c7, rook takes c7, and rook takes c7, check here by the queen, and then what follows is rook d1. So the back rank of Wesley is really weak now. So this move could just be ignored. I would not put additional protection on this because black can just ignore it. Okay, what happened here? Knight to d5, I think it threatens to go to b4, and Wesley responded with knight e1, protecting the g2 square from the mating threat of the black queen. So the queen here at e4 is very is a very optimally placed or in an optimum position for black, because it threatens a lot of things. It threatens mate here when the time is ripe for the queen to strike. If, for example, this knight is taken out. Okay, so I think the threat here is, so it's Mamedyarov's turn. Mamedyarov could go knight b4 here. He could go knight b4 and then knight d3, threatening to remove the defender on the g2 square. So if knight b4, Wesley would be forced to go rook c3 to protect this square from the knight. However, if rook c3, then you have knight a2, forking the rook. So I think this is a lost position for Wesley here. Except if there is a counterplay. For example, knight b4, and Wesley would just ignore the threat on c2, and Wesley would just go f3. I think f3 is the correct move here, because rook c3 would not work. Oh, sorry. If rook c3 and if knight a2, actually knight a2 is not possible. I didn't saw it immediately because of queen takes a2. Okay, so knight a2 is not possible even if I have here rook c3. But rook c3 is a passive move because it does not threaten anything. What black would just make a waiting move after that. So what I was thinking before was f3. But Wesley did this rook d2. Actually, this is a good move for Wesley because he is trying to remove as much pieces on the board so that the black attack would filter down or would just dissipate. So this is a good move from Wesley here, this rook d2. It is putting the ball to the black side, saying, so what now? Sorry, got a cough here. So this is Roland of Pinoyu Chess, and I also have my other channel, a Wesley So Fan channel, but I've still not uploaded many video there, but I think I would be uploading this video both in my Pinoyu Chess channel and my Wesley So Fan channel. Okay? So this is an exciting game here. So Mamedyarov starting to use his time more here. So this rook d2 by Wesley is actually a good move, as proven by the fact that black is actually consuming more time, and just a few seconds from now, Wesley and Mamedyarov's times would be almost equal. if Wesley would be able to draw this, I would be already satisfied with such a result. Okay, Wesley's time would be equal to Mamedyarov now, and Wesley would even have more time. So we could play the coverage video and see what's being analyzed right now. I can play it. Let's refresh. Let's see if I can play the video if I refresh.
Of course I wanted to grab. Are you kidding me? Of course I wanted to grab the pawn.
Rook They're takes, analyzing a different queen, game right now. C2, of course, because that square please is go to Wesley's
the
game, C1 please.
Does threaten me with a checkmate, forcing me to play bishop g2, and now maybe you can cuddle up to this guy? No, then I can trade and go king g2. Do you have
I
a
have
way?
Have queen d2 at least.
Queen David 2.
We have an expression for this.
What's that?
Playing for the loss.
Playing for the loss.
I mean,
because there is a nice win here for.
No, for black, you're playing for a loss. Why are you giving up h6?
I don't know.
Okay. I mean,
I thought we were trying to get
to
queen h1 to checkmate, actually. Okay,
let's
so you
go back.
You reckon after rook b6, you should.
Let's refresh again. I don't want their game, because I want them to focus on Wesley. So let's go back to this game. So what actually the rook was exchanged. So Wesley made the move rook d2, and Mamedyarov did take on d2, and then queen takes d2, and then here, this is what I missed. I didn't saw this rook a7 threatening rook 8-2. So what would happen there? But actually, is that a good move? I could go queen d8 by Wesley. Oh no, not queen d8. Wesley just did queen d7 threatening. It's actually threatening queen c8, then king h7, and queen takes h3. If rook a2, I would not immediately take on h3. I would want to take h3 with a tempo. Right, guys? That would be better if with a tempo. So, check first at c8. So that's what Wesley is threatening now, to check on c8 first. And then, if of course, the only move is king h7 for black, then queen takes h3. Wesley had already equalized here. And it shows that because Mamedyarov is already consuming more time, had consumed more time than Wesley. So it's I think it's almost midnight now, but I am not yet sleepy because I'm enjoying this game. But I don't know if I could proceed with the next game here, because I still have work tomorrow. Come on, Mamedyarov, make the move. So Mamedyarov here is having a difficult time converting his position, or actually he has lost the initiative here, especially now that he is down on time. So he was forced to defend. He was forced to defend his back rank. So Wesley would just take the pawn on h3, and he's actually ahead now in the computer evaluation. Can we hide this computer evaluation? No, we can't. It's default. Maybe in the settings. Actually, I haven't explored the settings yet. It's just on the color of the board. So let's change the color of the board here. Let's try. So we have changed the color of the board. I don't like it. I'll just go to the previous board settings. Okay. So actually, Wesley took an h3 here. And again, it's Mamedyarov's time that's ticking down, and he has less than 5 minutes, going 4 minutes now. So what happened is just Wesley is now ahead in terms of material. He's one pawn up here. So after this, Wesley has to consolidate his position. He has to make some form of consolidation. Oh, he Mamedyarov has forced the exchange of the knight. So what would Wesley do? Of course, take the knight. There's nothing else to do there. And I think this is a seems to have has a tendency to get drawn, because the pawn at the b3 pawn of white is unprotected, although the computer says that white is ahead. There is a big chance that Mamedyarov can really hold this position, because Wesley can't defend the b3 pawn here. And still, Wesley can't think of attacking yet, because he has a weak back rank. So he has to find a way to protect his back rank, or to ensure that he does not get mated by any misadventures or blunder on his part. So what would Wesley do here? And Wesley just so that's a good move there. I was thinking of ways to defend the b3 pawn, but the b3 pawn could just move. What a no-brainer. Oh, the problem here for Wesley is that Black would have a passed pawn. It's a good one from Wesley. because he immediately recovers the pawn. So let's see if they are analyzing Wesley's game.
We have on the board still one extra pawn for white. The tactic knight f4 is on the board.
You're not analyzing Wesley's game. Don't like it. So what happened here is that Mamedyarov's queen did go to c3, and then Wesley took on the b5 with the queen, and then Mamedyarov initiated an exchange of rooks. So what happened is check, takes, goes up, and then it's Mamedyarov's trying to make a move. So right now there is no danger of Wesley losing this position or this game, because he can always do a perpetual check here, especially that his queen is at Queen is at the white square. Could always make a check. So if c5 here, then Wesley would be able to recover the pawn with a check on h3, and then if king g8, queen c8. So what Mamedyarov did is, instead of c5, he made the move c6 so that the pawn is protected by the white queen. Mamedyarov should be careful. So that's a very good move from Mamedyarov there. Wow, g4 by Wesley. It's a genius move because if queen takes h4 and then queen takes f7 by Wesley. Okay, I think this position is really cool. And the pawn passer is really not that dangerous because if c5 and then the white king of Wesley could always go into the square, the queening the count of the queening square. I don't know the correct term for that, but what's important is that the king could always catch up with the pawn. I think this is a blunder from Mamedyarov because Wesley would be able to force the exchange of queens here. That's it. I am forcing the exchange of queens. And I could go fairly complicated position, but there is no risk for of losing on the part of Wesley. But if you want him to win, then he has to do something extraordinary here. So that's it. I'm thinking of e4 actually, because this would be able to take the white queen out of the action. Problem is with the e4 move, you always have to protect that e4 pawn. Okay, so Wesley is doing something here. Queen e7 runs into c4. So this is a draw. Don't you think, guys? Because you white should always protect the e4 pawn. So this is a draw, I think. Or the king could go to g3, and if check, f3. Wesley could force the perpetual check right now, but he could try g3 and then f3 if ever Mamedyarov decides to check. C4, do you think C4 is a good move for black? I think Wesley is playing time against Mamedyarov here. Whoa! H5, this forces Mamedyarov to think, because this came out of the blue. You wouldn't expect this H5 thing here. So it forces Mamedyarov to think, and after g takes h5, then you have g6. Wow! I haven't seen it coming. Wesley is really good at tactics here. Even tactics that is not so obvious immediately. So Wesley knows his end game. He knows this trick. And he just... he just wait for the position to come up so that he could play this trick. And since the pawn is protected, now there's Mamedyarov still has this trick. Queen d3. What if I just ignore that and h takes g6 by Wesley, and then queen takes d5, the e4 pawn takes d5, c3, d6, c2, d7, c1, queen, and then d8, queen. Check, but with a check. And Wesley wins, because there is queen f6, and the and king g8, and then queen takes f7 check, and then king f7, and then queen h7 checkmate. Bam! I saw it coming, so my analysis is correct. Wow! I really love that, how I get that analysis. So Wesley just won, guys. So if we continue this game, what happens is that we can actually move this, make a move for this. That's the beauty of chess 24. You can make a move for yourself, And then if there's a race to the queening square, actually black would win the race, but Wesley wins with a check. So you have here queen, and then Wesley also queens. Okay, and then of course the only move is this one, king g7, and then Wesley goes here, and then the only move is if king f8, of course there is immediate checkmate. So if it goes here, king g8, check, and then checkmate. Wow, I really love this. Wesley is almost losing in the middle game, but he won with this wonderful mating net, although it's not executed because Mamedyarov had already resigned. But Wesley saw it coming, saw that it would happen, and saw that great, wonderful, genius h5 move. So congratulations, Wesley. I think you are now ahead. A win is worth 2 points, so you are now 4 points. And for now, the Nakamura, the Aronian and Nakamura game is still pending. So only Aronian, only Nakamura has a chance to catch up with Wesley. But however, it seems that Nakamura is losing. Okay, so Nakamura is losing here. So it's not possible for him to catch up with Wesley. So Wesley takes the lead in this game. So thank you again for watching, guys. And see you and watch my third video.